Hey, welcome YouTube. Quick informational video on some AC work. Clearwater, Florida, we do a lot of this, of course. And I've got a 94 Ford Explorer Sport. Believe it or not, runs great. My parents' vehicle, so I'm gonna shoot a video on this. I've already evacuated the Freon out, obviously, in the business. We're regulated by the EPA, and we have to evacuate, recover, and put Freon back in for ozone, be licensed to do AC. So do-it-yourselfers can go to a shop, have them pull the Freon out, do the work, go back to the local shop and have them charge it back up for them. That's the best way to cover a problem like that, okay? So let's begin. I said 1994 Ford Explorer Sport. AC compressor locked up. Let me show you that. Right there, you can see it's burnt, just smoked. All right, Ford FX10, I believe, or FX15 compressor. I'll see exactly which one it is. Pretty common, they do a thing called Black Death, put a soot through the whole system. So any more of these kits are relatively inexpensive. We change the compressor, the filter, the orifice tube, we flush it out, and we change the condenser. So quite an extensive job, but do-it-yourself can change parts, I'm sure you can handle this. So let's go over the parts real fast that I got on my table. We're using this parts through a wholesale AC distributor, C409OM by 1-800 Radiator and AC. Compressor comes completely full of oil. Sometimes that can be too much. So a lot of times I drain it. We got to flush it out with this flush right here. Okay. This car calls for a PAG 46 oil if we need to add anything to it. It comes with new R134A fittings and Schraders and caps. Part numbers on that. Comes with all new O-rings. This set here. Here's your red or burgundy, it looks like to me, O-tube. Part number on that. Okay, we also get an accumulator filter, which is this one, and that's this part right here. So let's begin. First thing I want to do is pull the air snorkel off just to access us some room right here, because I'm pulling that condenser and things out of there. It's what's today? The 6th of June, I believe. And we're probably running about 88 degrees right now in the morning. And that's cool for us. I might have to wear a sweater here in a little bit, Byron. I turned the fans off, but we get a lot of background noise from other jobs and things going on. So sometimes it gets hard to hear. Sometimes I talk too soft, so I'm gonna try to pay attention to that. If I have to kick some fans on, sorry, you're gonna hear background noise, but we're not gonna burn up so much, even though it's hot anyway. All right, I wanna take the belt off right here, serpentine belt. Down underneath, spring tensioner. Use your 3/8 ratchet, come underneath and take the tension off and remove the belt. Right in a slot just behind the pulley. Move it forward, peel the belt out of there. Byron, you're up top. Can you peel it off the compressor? Offload or overflow. Okay. My ratchet stuck. We'll fix that. Okay, so the belt's off. Just your 3/8 ratchet, swivel head, get your belt out of there. Just let it lay down inside there. Let's unplug our compressor, a little clip here. Unplug the power to our compressor. The next thing you got, go ahead and loosen the 10 millimeter bolt that's behind the compressor manifold lines right here. I've already evacuated the Freon, pulled it down to a little bit of vacuum, so I didn't show that. Didn't feel there was a need to do that. So that holds the manifold hose assembly on. Watch your eyes. Sometimes even though you evacuate them, there still can be pressure there, but we're good. A lot of times you can just loosen this up and notch it out. There's the bolt. So he's going to answer that phone while trying to hold video for us.
Thank you for calling Cooper's Automotive. He is not available at the moment. Is there something I can help you with? Okay, let me take your name and number.
Okay, so there's a bracket on this hose right here. The manifold just behind the belt. He had to take care of that phone. So we've lost a little bit of visual. You're gonna need to take that off so that you can remove the manifold up out of your way. Just a small little 8 millimeter there. Now, ought to give us plenty of room to wiggle that compressor out of there. All right, so you got the manifold up. I'm going to go ahead and take these little retainers off. Save these to put them back on their safety so the line don't blow out. And they got special release tools for those. They look like this. You gotta find the size that fits around the pipe. It goes in and it pushes against a spring, a little round spring inside there to release it. And they are a pain in the neck. I think that's the right size, but let's make sure. Yep, that one's too big. So we'll battle through this one. You usually can see it push down into the line. We're not being successful at the moment. Look like you're working harder or something. I love it when you go to the gym, they start hollering and carrying on. You're like, really? You guys are dying. You need to go home. I'll be back. I'm gonna see if I can get a pair of pliers. Alright, so I try to get it up underneath the spring. Get a little press action there. You can see it go down in like that, and it should be released at that point. pull up on the line and start wiggling it out. There you go. There's a spring down inside there, and it locks around the head of this accumulator, and that's what holds the line on. So that's out. There's going to be a few of those. Let's move this up and out of our way. Right there. Let's go ahead and take this accumulator off since we're on this side. It's got a plug here for a low pressure AC cycling switch. Clip underneath the bottom of it. And I think it's broken already on the feel of it. Turn this, hopefully we'll be able to see it better that way. Turn it up, there it is. There's no clip on that. You can replace these plug-ins, but try to pull them close. We're gonna reuse this, so go ahead and screw it off of there. Save that for install. Take this right off here. I'm using a inch and a 16th and combination 2022, it fits. Pull them together like this. These can be really, really tight sometimes. Once you get it loose, you won't need the 22 on the accumulator side anymore. Seems it's just about weld on sometimes. You almost have to replace the evaporator from the difference of the metal accumulator, metal nuts, and electrolysis building up on the lines. And once you get that out of there, there's a 10 millimeter little band that goes around the accumulator on the bottom. Try to get to that right down here. Don't know if you can see it. Right in the bottom. Byron, can you get a picture of that? I'll move that out of the way. It is right, well, it's not even a 10. Excuse me. Well, that's interesting. Let's just see if it'll slide up out of here for a second. Otherwise, I do have to release that clamp. There you go. Now you can show that little band that holds it down there. So, got that as I'm burning up. And this is the accumulator, the old one. Airplane part. Okay, we'll pick it up later. All right, so we got that out of the way. Let me see where. Okay, the screw's on the back side back here. Fortunately, we didn't have to take it off, but we probably will because underneath that is a liquid line. And it feels like there's 8 or a 10, might be a 10 still, I'm not sure. It's on this side. Well, it feels like an 8. See if we can get it loose. I will probably drop it, but I hope not. So far I'm good. Okay, take that out. You can see now that that's moving, but there's a wire harness bolted to it on the front. Of course. And it's also an 8. We'll take that one out. We want to get that ring out of the way because we're trying to access room to the liquid line, which is underneath all this. That fits in between the casing of the evaporator. And there's one more actually down there that is connected to the liquid line. So it's gonna come out. They didn't want that band to get out of there in any way. Looks like it's loose and it's wet. What do we say, Byron? We say that being an auto mechanic has taught us a lot of words. Patience is one of them. And the others I cannot even say on camera. That's my little joke for the day. All right. So that's out of there. Underneath that, you see the liquid line right there. Let's figure out what size those are. We're gonna take that apart because down inside that is that little orifice valve. And we're gonna see how much garbage is stuck on that thing. I don't have any other American wrenches, size wrenches here, but let's start with Let's start with a 19 on this side. Probably use that 22 on the other side. I'm gonna pull this hose up. There's a lot of wires and things in the way, so I hope you guys are seeing this little liquid line. It's on the passenger side running by the fender well down here. Yeah, we gotta get that loose. .22 is really a snug fit, but let's see if it holds enough to loosen it. You can use channel, what do you call them, adjustable wrenches? Oh, that is really tight. Extremely tight. Much luck today. Uh-oh. Probably better off just get the right wrench, right, you guys? Trying not to walk back and forth to my toolbox. Okay, Byron, switch positions with me so I can get over there and get some pulling. Here we go. Typically, once you get them loose, it's not too bad. I'm gonna say 22 is not what this is. But it did get us through there. Sorry about that one, guys. I just, like I said, I don't want to keep track of back and forth and losing time to the toolbox. I'm burning up. But that's just the way it is. Feels like it's loose enough to turn by hand until you try it. right? All right, so you get that off and disconnect that line right there. And inside of that is a little orifice valve. I'm gonna get needle nose in there and hopefully I can pull it out. We hope. Reaching down through the fender here. Try to get a straight on fit, can't. Try to do it this way. I know you can't see this, but it's the bottom line going to the evap. I pulled it out a little bit, Myron, if you want to show them, then I'll just reach down and grab it. See that? That's it. That's what you're pulling out. Note the angle of it, or the way that it went in. And there's not too much crud on it, so that's pretty good. This one's a blue one. We're going to research why, because the orifice colors make the difference in the orifice size, the cooling capacity of the AC system. All right? I've seen them covered in black soot. This only has a little bit. So that's kind of nice. Set that to the side. We're going to go after the compressor next.
Excuse me, sir.
The compressor's held on by 4 10-millimeters. I'm going to use air on this. So you get to hear that nice noise. We're going to pull this compressor off. Got 4 10-millimeter long bolts going through the housing of the AC compressor. Let's get those suckers out of there. There we are. 4 long bolts. All the way by that. Usually there's guide pins on these that set them down into the bracket. One in the front, one in the front. So we got 2 in the front fit down inside there. You want to put those back in. Compressor's off. Now we have to pull this AC condenser out of here, which is in front of the radiator. First thing I want to do is remove these clip right here from the condenser. So again, the safety lock. And another one of those spring tool, and this has been leaking. You can see the black on it. It's been leaking. So get new O-rings on that anyway. Probably come with the new condenser. Let's get our little release tools. Same thing you saw me do with the evaporator. Push it up in there. That one went right in. Twist the line, pull it out. There's your high side line. We'll clean this up. That's being replaced. Should be one on the other side. There is. So you got a retainer on the other side. Let me get my light. Walk away light. Okay. One right there on the other side. This is the passenger side. You can grab that, pull it out, set it off to the side, get your spring lock removal tools again. Find the right size, snap it around the line, push it into the springs, and I like to twist the line a little bit. pull it out. Now that one's released, just let it sit right there. We gotta pull the radiator forward, which is a 13, I believe, millimeter right there. Let's find out. That's a 13. And we'll save you noise, I'll use a ratchet. Should have got my magnetic tray to hold all my bolts. They'll probably end up under the battery, you guys. It's usually how it works. So you got one on each side of that. All right, and obviously that side's been out. That's a different size. I don't even know what it is. We're using a 12. Old vehicle, you never know what you're gonna find. All right, so you're gonna lean this radiator. Being careful you don't hit the fan. And just pull it forward like that. But over the top of that, you notice it's got the jack bar. We're gonna take it out of our way. And we're just gonna set it back here for a minute. So we'll lean it forward. There's an 8 millimeter in the top right there. And there's an 8 over there. And if all goes well,